ओम नमः शिवाय। सो ये कंप्यूटर हैज सिस्टम, द कंप्यूटर सिस्टम हैज हार्डवेयर एंड सॉफ्टवेयर। सो हार्डवेयर्स आर नथिंग बट फिजिकल पार्ट्स ऑफ द कंप्यूटर, दे आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज पेरिफेरल्स। एंड सॉफ्टवेयर इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग द सेट ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शंस विच आर कॉल्ड एज प्रोग्राम, एंड दैट गवर्न्स द ऑपरेशन ऑफ अ कंप्यूटर सिस्टम, एंड इट मेक्स द हार्डवेयर वर्क प्रॉपरली। सो हार्डवेयर कैन नॉट वर्क विदाउट सॉफ्टवेयर, because it doesn't have any brain, nothing, it can do nothing on its own. So depends on the instruction it receives, it works. So those instructions, set of instructions are called as software. So it behaves like a interface between hardware and user. So to make use of hardware, user need to use this software. Okay, so with its help, the user can give the directions to the system. So that directions are called as instructions, and set of instructions are called as program. So we have a set of program, a pack of program for running each hardware part of the system. Software actually gives directions to the different parts of the computer to work properly. Okay, so software is of two major types. So they are called as system software and application software. So mainly software is divided into two type, that is system software and application software. Okay, so this is how the system software acts as a mediator between the hardware and the upper layer of application software, and the application software is again reached by this user. Okay, so the user can contact the application software, that again receives informations and sends information to the system software. The system software actually makes the hardware parts work properly. So this is how it works. So the software that controls the inner operation of the computer, okay, so that it is called as system software. So the software which controls the inner operations of a computer is called as system software. So it follows the instructions related to the system, and it facilitates the smooth working of the system. Okay, so it has a list of instructions which makes the system, that means the hardware, to work properly. So it is not possible to work without the system software. We cannot even switch on the machine without the system software. So that we need a system software to make use of this computer. Okay, it works as an interface between this hardware and the application software. Application softwares or another set of software, we will see about that. It is further divided into two parts. System software is again divided into two types. One is operating system, the other type is language processor. So both are actually working directly with the hardware devices, and both the operating system as well as the language processor, these both are very important for the working of a computer. Okay, we will see what is operating system. An operating system is a program. It acts as an interface between the hardware and the user. Okay, excuse me. It is like a major manager of the whole computer system. It manages each activity of the whole system. Okay, so it coordinates every part of the system. So all the resources, actually the hardware of the system is called as the resources. These resources are properly coordinated and managed by this OS, that means operating system. It manages various application softwares with the hardware. Okay, then it develops an environment, easy to use environment for the user, and then it gives commands to the outputs, input and output. Okay, it can give commands to the system. So what it does, operating system is a program which acts like an interface between the hardware and the application software, which is again used by the user. It is like a manager of the whole system, and it controls all the resources, which are again called as hardware. Hardware is actually the resources of the system. It manages the various application softwares, and it develops an environment which makes the user to use the computer very conveniently. Okay, and then different types of OSs. What are the different types of OS, operating systems? So first type is single user OS. So some of the systems, some of the OS will be used, can be used only by the single user. Example for this is DOS, disk operating system. Okay, multi-user OS. So multi-user OS will be used in the network. Okay, network connections. So there will be number of machines connected together, like in an organization. So there will be many number of machines will be there. Many workers will be working together. Okay, like Unix, no? Unix is an OS which is used for multi-user supporting system, because in Unix, if you have installed, Unix will have a server. So this OS will be installed in the server, and the server will serve many clients. Okay, it's a client server technology. So the many clients will use that server operating system. So it is called as multi-user OS. So the users, many number of users can use the same OS. They can share it, okay, from the server. So that it is called as multi-user OS. So next, time sharing OS and real time OS are there. Time sharing OS means the resources will be shared properly. The sharing of the resources will be maintained by the OS. Okay, operating system will give proper management for sharing the resources of the computer system. So for example, if you are in a scanner scanning, if you are using a big scanning machine, or if you have a bigger printer machine, that can be shared using some special operating system software. So that is called as time sharing OS. And real time OS is like a modeling software. We have no pilot projects like that. So they will create some real systems with all the realistic elements in that. So that can be executed, that can be actually worked in with the usage of real time OS. Then multi processing OS will be useful for running multiple tasks, okay, at a time, so that it will run concurrently. Many process can be done at the same time concurrently. So that is called multiple processing operating system. That is also called as multiprocessing operating system. Then distributed OS. So distributed OS is used for in database management systems, or in the cloud storage we used to say nowadays, because there will be a central storage machine. The main important information or the total amount of data will be stored in that machine, and that can be distributed to the clients and other networks using this distributed OS. So these are the different types of OS. Once again, I'll read out: single user OS, multi user OS, time sharing OS, real time OS, multi processing OS, and distributed OS. That's it. We will know only this much about this OS, because we don't have it is our syllabus. No, we have only this much, so it's enough. Then we will see what is language processor. A language means in normal life we use many languages, no, like English, Tamil, for the communication, for sharing our thoughts and ideas. We use this language. So for program, for in terms of computer, we have different languages which actually has can create set of instructions which tells the computer to work in different ways. Okay, that is actually called computer language. And we have what we are using, no, they are called as high level language. That means we can use normal English words in that, but a system, a computer, cannot understand that language because it's just a machine. So that it should be converted, what we are typing, no, the high level program, high level language program, must be converted into the machine understandable format. So the machine understandable code is called as object code. Okay, what we are writing is called as high level language code, and it will be converted into object code which is understandable by the machine. So for conversion of this thing from high level to the object code, we use language processors. Understand? For the conversion of high level language programming code to the object code is called as we use language processor. Okay, for example, we have many languages: C, C++, Java, Python. So each programming language will have a converter. Okay, the converter may be an assembler, interpreter, or compiler. So there are three types of converters, that means language processors, and they does the conversion in different ways. Okay, so object code refers to the code usually which is understandable by the machine, and it will be usually in the binary format. Okay, binary code, it is usually in the binary format, and that is the only format which machine can understand, the hardware can understand. So language processors, the three type of language processors, the first one is assembler, the second one is interpreter, third one is compiler. There is another language called assembly language. Okay, there are three categories of language we can say. Simply, high level language will be written completely with normal English. Machine code will be written. Machine code consists only the binary codes. Okay, only zeros and ones. That is called machine code. So in between there is a language called assembly language. It has the binary code as well as some symbolic instructions. Okay, so that is called assembly language. Understand, that is not high level language, and they are not machine level language also. It is not completely written by binary code also. So but it's a combination of some symbolic instructions and with the binary code, they are called as assembly language. Okay, the software which is used for converting this assembly language into machine language is called as assembler. The software which translates the assembly language program into the machine language program is called as the assembler. Then we have interpreter. So interpreter and compiler, both of them will do the conversion of high level program into the machine level program. Okay, but the difference between these two are, and then it will first convert it and then it will execute it. Both the work it will do, both of that, interpreter as well as the compiler, both will do the conversion first, then it will execute also. But the difference between interpreter and compiler is very simple. Interpreter will do the conversion line by line. Okay, or some unit by unit it will do the conversion. That means the high level language will be converted into machine language one by one, line by line. So instruction by instruction interpreter will convert and give the result immediately. But compiler, it will convert the whole program in one go. Okay, so if you are writing a big program or big project, if you are designing, then the whole program will be converted into machine language first, then it executes it as a whole thing. Okay, so here if there are errors, it give error. If there may be errors every time when you write a program, it contains so many bugs which are also called as errors. So if an error occurs, no, if you are running it, if interpreter is used, it displays in the same line itself. Okay, so only if the line is corrected, then only it can run the next line, because interpreter runs the conversion line by line. So once the line is correct, no, without any errors, if it is error free, then only it will further proceed to the next line. But in terms of compiler, it converts the complete program into the machine code first. So finally after the conversion, it shows the error with the line number. Okay, so that is how it corrects the errors. So we have to know this clearly. Understand? If you have any doubt, you can ask again. So interpreter does the conversion line by line, compiler does it in one go. So errors will be immediately corrected using interpreter, because once a line has error or bugs, means it should be corrected, then only the interpreter can continue to the next line. But here in the compiler, because it is converting the complete high level program into the machine language first, the errors will be displayed at last once it starts executing. So that errors will display along with the line numbers, right? So once the error is removed, we will get the output. Okay, so the output result only will be suspended. So until the error is corrected, the result we cannot see correctly. So this is what how the programs are executed using interpreter as well as the compiler. Understand? So next we have, so this is till now we have seen about the system software. Okay, so system software, we have two kinds of system software, OS and a language processor. OS is the operating system, which is mainly used for the operation of the computer, and language processor is for the conversion of high level to machine language. We have three kinds of language processors. Now we are going to see about the application software. What is application software? Application software is set of program which is necessary for carrying out some special operations. Okay, for a specific application, it is not common like general purpose, it is a specific purpose application. Okay, there are to be installed some special files to be installed after the installation of OS. Okay, so the application software works on top of the OS, so we need to install OS first. So on top of that only this application software will work. The application software alone cannot be used for working on the machines. Understand? So it works on top of the OS. So we need a OS to be installed to work with the application software. Next, OS provides an environment to run the application software. So without OS, application software cannot run. So these are designed for some specific purpose, because each OS has its own objective. With that only it will be created. For example, we have a packages, different kind of there are four categories of application software. In application software there are four categories. So first one is packages. Packages is like a bundle of software which will be dedicated for a group of activities. Okay, for example, we can say MS Office. In MS Office we have a collection of different elements which helps us to create office related works. Okay, maybe a word processor which is used for creating, editing documents, and a spreadsheet for entering into the tabular columns, and a presentation software like PowerPoint presentation is used for presenting our meetings and presenting our project. So many things are there. So presentation, so these are generally used for office purpose. So that is a core collection of MS Office. So these kind of application software are called as packages. So like MS Office, we have some other packages like Adobe is there, then Macromedia collections are there. So for different purpose, they serve for different purpose. Adobe is for mainly graphical purpose and Macromedia is for animations. Okay, so we have different collections, packages for different purposes. And then second category of application software is utilities. Okay, utilities means, okay, packages we have seen. So only the system, word processing software, spreadsheet, these are the example for packages. And then we have desktop publishing software, DTP we used to say, desktop publishing software for the printing purpose. Okay, like for example, we are going to print a book or newspaper, we can use all those package of software, and presentation applications are also there. Then we have utility programs. Utility programs are type of system software which creates some workable environment for the user. Within the application software, these are like smaller general purpose softwares. Okay, because it serves for many purposes. Some small but very important purpose, we can use utility software like compression of the file, zipping and unzipping of the file, then defragmenting the disk. Okay, then antivirus software, a text editor, a common text editor like Notepad. So many things are there. They are coming under utility software. Okay, they perform some various range of works, but it will be not a very big project. It will be like smaller things. Okay, so they are called as utility tools. Then they also work on top of OS only. Then variety, different type of utility software. What are they? So antivirus, file management tool, disk management, disk defragmenter, all these are called as utility software. What is antivirus? You know very well. So computer, to safeguard the computer from the virus attacks. Okay, so whenever it detects a virus, it notify the user that there is an attack, or it deletes, it does some preventive actions like deleting it or putting it in archive. Like that, it does some preventive activities. So that is called antivirus utility. And then file management tool is there. It manages the complete file storage. Okay, copying the file, creating mini copies, or moving the file from one place to another place. Like that. Okay, then what is that? Completely traversing the files, how many files are there, like that, searching for a file. All these things can be done by the file management tool. And then we have disk management. So the disks, in the disks, the datas will be not arranged in an orderly manner. So wherever it finds free space, it fills it up. So we can do the disk management, like rearranging, freeing up the unused spaces and making it in as a continuous, okay, contiguous space. All these things can be done by disk management software, and they are used in the secondary disk storages like flash drive, optical disk, and hard disk drive. We can do this, okay. And then we have some customized softwares. These are the fourth category. So we have seen first packages, then we have seen what is utility software, then different type of utility, then this is third type of application software, which is called as customized software. What is customized software? Special software, application software, which serves up a special purpose. Basically, it will be for some business requirements, for satisfying some business requirements. Okay, like for example, we can say inventory management system, hospital management system, hotel management system, payroll system, financial accounting like tally software does, no? And for designing, AutoCAD, so many things are there, reservation systems are there. So all these thing serves a specific purpose. Basically, it relies on some business. Okay, so these are customized for some business activities. So those are called as customized softwares. Then we have software libraries. These are the fourth category. We have software libraries for the developers, those who are developing the softwares. No, they, for them there are set of software libraries. That means pre-returned programs will be there available for them, ready to use. They no need to write, keep on writing the programs which are already available. Okay, so it will be freely redistributable. They can easily simply download it and use it in their program. So they are called as software library. Like in the library, we can take the books and use it. No, like that. Some general purpose codes will be pre-returned and stored in the general storage. That means which is commonly available for everybody. So that can be utilized by those programmers who are in need. So that is called a software library. Each programming language, every programming language, almost they have software libraries. For example, in our Python, we have NumPy library, Panda library, we have MATLAB library, Matplotlib library. So many libraries are there in our Python software. And in C, C++, Java, in other languages also, we can see the libraries available. Different packages will be there. So they'll be the libraries may be called by different names. Okay, packages they'll say, in sometimes they are called library. So different names are there, but they are like the applications which are already written and that can be easily used.